In this video, you'll learn about updating to AWS Control Tower Landing Zone version 3.0. With this version, you can enable organization-level AWS CloudTrail trails, utilize expanded region-deny guardrail features, and reduce the amount of AWS Config resources needed. From the AWS Control Tower dashboard, let's start by opening the Landing Zone settings. We'll select version number 3.0 and initiate the update. The first step, to update region settings, is optional. Let's move on to step 2. The version 3.0 update introduces an optional configuration that reorganizes your organization's AWS CloudTrail trails from account-based into organization-based trails. If you enable this configuration, AWS Control Tower creates an organization-level CloudTrail trail and aggregates logs into your organization's existing Amazon Simple Storage Service or Amazon S3 bucket associated with Control Tower. Enabling this feature will replace any account-level trails provisioned by AWS Control Tower. However, you are responsible for eliminating any other account-level trails and reestablishing the file paths for third-party logging tools if necessary. Let's confirm the acknowledgement and proceed. Here, we can review our choices and then choose to update our landing zone. For now, let's return to the previous page. If you opt out of organization-level CloudTrail trails, AWS Control Tower will stop managing your AWS CloudTrail trails. Control Tower will delete your account-level trails, although logging data already in the specified Amazon S3 bucket will stay intact. Also, Control Tower will not create any new trails, though your organization can create and manage trails on its own. To proceed, we must acknowledge these terms. We must also enter text stating that we want to stop all trails. Let's confirm and move on. Now we'll review our selections and update the landing zone. Landing Zone version 3.0 also expands the AWS Control Tower region deny guardrail to include additional AWS chatbot, Amazon S3 storage lens, and Amazon S3 multi-region access points APIs. The region deny guardrail assists you in limiting access to AWS services and operations for enrolled accounts in your Control Tower environment. This helps ensure that any customer data you upload to AWS services is located only in the AWS regions that you specify. Further, Landing Zone 3.0 now records global resources in home regions only. This configuration creates cost savings by reducing the number of configuration items created when global resources are created, modified, or deleted. You've just learned about updating to AWS Control Tower Landing Zone version 3.0. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.